Are pets worth it in Thieves? And should you spend your hard-earned cash on these in-game pets? Well, in this video, we're going to find out whether they're worth it and could they be improved in any way. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more Thieves content on the horizon. Well, to understand if they're worth it or not, we first need to take a look at how much they cost and if you can obtain pets without spending real money. So we can see the cost of around 499 ancient coins, which is around £5 in the UK. So it's not exactly breaking the bank, but that doesn't mean it's still worth the money. So if you do want to spend real money, the only way you can obtain ancient coins in the game is through season rewards and also from finding those rare ancient skeletons. But just remember, they are rare, so don't expect to counter these that often. But saying that, not always lost, you do seem to earn a lot of ancient coins just from the season themselves. In this current season, you get around about 300 ancient coins, and that is if you don't own the Plunder Pass. If you do own the Plunder Pass, well, you're going to get way more. So if you was thinking about getting a pet and you don't earn enough in the season rewards, all you have to do is make it to the max level where they stop giving out the ancient coins, or just try and complete the Pirate Renowned. It isn't too difficult and you can get those levels up really easy, and you have a lot of time to complete it as well. And then all those you just earned from the Pirate Renowned, you could combine with buying some ancient coins, but you no longer need to buy the 499, which is around Fiverr. You can buy a smaller amount and add it with your current ancient coins, and you save yourself some money there. So given that pets do look amazing and the animations are done really well, they can cause a slight problem when it comes to giving away your position, especially if you managed to board another player's ship and you didn't get the chance to put your pet away. Now, you can dismiss your pet by going to the crew management settings, but that means if you get discovered while dismissing your pet, then you have a zero chance of defending yourself, and you're going to be sent to the ferryman. Now, this could be solved with a dismiss function when you look at your pet, and it will have a little dismiss button, and that way, regardless of your playstyle, if you like to go on board and talk and you just love that PvP action, then you can still have your pet out while you play the game, and it's not going to cause you any drama. To those who love more the PvE side of things, then you won't really experience this kind of problem. Also, later on in the video, we're going to discuss some really cool ideas that can become way more useful without creating an unfair advantage to other players. Now, do you agree with me that they are slightly boring? You may have a different opinion, but for me, they are basically a walking cosmetic, when they do have the potential to be so much more. For example, do they really need to follow your player everywhere? Could they not, for example, explore and interact with the island itself, but you know, still stay within the radius of where you are and you can see the pet? For example, there are planks of wood scattered on the beach which the pet could pick up and essentially play with. Or even, can you imagine having the monkeys go and climb trees? It just adds a bit more life to them. And you can control this by having commands in the game, which we will discuss later on in the video, or even having a whistle function, so you can call your pet to you. This to me doesn't create an unfair advantage to anyone else, but also makes the pets feel more interesting and gives them more life. So I feel we have to discuss some of the bad side of things when it comes to pets, but now let's start to talk about some of their potential, and maybe certain updates could really improve the experience when it comes to having these pets. So one cool function is you could have your pet to alert you when an enemy player is within a certain radius of you by going crazy and making noises. And to make this a fair advantage to everyone, they could give you a basic pet, maybe like a rat or a squirrel. Now, it wouldn't tell you where the enemy are and it wouldn't tell you what direction they're in, so it was not really creating that much of an unfair advantage. They could still surprise attack you. But to make it interesting, they could also alert you when like skeletons and ocean crawlers spawn, because that way you're not sure if it's going to be another player or if it's just creatures spawning around you. So it's going to be up to you whether you take that warning signal as an enemy player or creatures could even tell you when skeleton ships are near. So you'll never truly know what that alert signal means. Another great way that these pets can be helpful is to new players. So what could happen is you could be on a big island like Old Faithful. And let's just say, for example, you are struggling to locate the area of an X marked a spot, because we've all had that one, and it centers around the bend. And that's when the pet comes in. What it could do is, once you've arrived near one of the X marked a spot's dig locations, it could start to circle the area in which you are so you can find it better, because at least you know you're in the right area. Now, it wouldn't tell you where to dig, but at least you know you're in the right area and you're not wasting time looking on the other side of the island. And nobody will be missing out, because everyone would have been given a free pet. Now, this idea is more of a quality of life idea, because pets could carry a small piece of treasure, and hold them for you, which would half the time you need to carry the items back to your ship. If you didn't have one of those treasure chests, then not only does it help you, but it gives you more functionality to the pets. And for me, it just adds to that game experience. Also, the pets could get scared when it comes to hearing gunshots from skeletons or other players, and what they could do is run away and drop the treasure somewhere. Birds and monkeys could leave them in the trees, and dogs could bury them. For cats, well, they could simply just sit on top of them and refuse to move. Cat owners will know what I'm on about here. You can feed pets in Sea of Thieves, but it doesn't do anything other than waste your supplies. But what if they had an energy bar, which works alongside them discovering the dig sites, and also alerting when enemies are near? And the lower the energy bar they have, then the bigger the radius it comes when it comes to locating treasure, which makes it harder for you to find. And also, when it comes to sensing enemies close, well, their sensors just aren't that strong, so the radius which they detect gets smaller, and that will allow players to sneak up. They could also add in some pet treats into the game, which will really greatly fill that energy bar up, and then regular food won't fill it up so much. You could also have it where if you didn't feed them often, they'll also get bored and hungry and maybe start damaging your ship with minor damages to the hull or even to the fabrics of your ship. Or they could also start to damage your treasure by chewing, pecking and even bashing it, and it'll start to lose value. We have beds on the ships where we can go and sleep, but there's no place for the pets to go and rest. Now if they add an area for your pets to rest, you can then have commands that open up in a wheel just like it does when you're viewing your quest maps. And one of these commands could say ship bed, and then that would mean when you are tucking, all you need to do is say the command to send them back to their ship, and off they go. If you get attacked, you're not stuck in the menus. You could have other commands like follow, patrol mode, sit, and alert mode, and I feel that would definitely make these pets worth it. If you could add a command, what would you add and why? So the question asks, are they worth it? And everybody will have their own opinion. For me, I don't believe they're worth spending money on, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't. If owning a pet in the game is something you want, then go ahead. However, if you got those ancient coins from the Pirate Renowned, then yes, I do believe pets are worth it. So just remember, before you buy one, you can actually get them in game. And also remember just to wait, sometimes they'll have offers on where you can get it at a discounted price and you'll save yourself a few ancient coins. Come join our Discord server, the link is in the description below. And also, why not click a video pin on the screen right now, you never know, you might enjoy it.